Alright, here we go. We'll give him the roll. There he goes. Okay, NCAA FGC just raided, so perfect timing. Thank you guys for coming through.
Let me know when the seating gets updated.
Yeah, hang on. Heck you. Where is he? What is his Smash GG?
Isn't it like Heck You or Heck Yourself or something like that?
Yeah, let me put Heck Yourself. Okay, no, that didn't work. Is it Heck You one word?
Probably.
Hang on, let me ask him. Heck You. Yeah. So we're just setting up. Thanks everybody for tuning in. We're setting up. We're doing some last minute setup. I'll just describe to you guys what's happening. Heck You is our final addition to the bracket. He registered late, but he registered at the exact cutoff. So we're trying to do this very hastily. It's gonna mess up seating quite a bit, but we'll be okay. You were the second to last, Naj, but you were not Heck You. You did not wait until the absolute last minute. So
does Naj still get the eyes?
Yeah, Naj did get the eyes. He was DMing me, so I didn't have Discord Nitro, so I couldn't give him the eyes. So he gave himself the eyes. Okay. Okay, so Heck You Smash UG is just, is Heck You one word. Okay. I'll make sure that was him. Let me make sure that was the correct Heck You. I actually don't think it was. I really wish Smash UG would work and like let me go to the profile of the player when I add them to the bracket. Yeah, now Heck You is complaining about seating, saying that now that he's finally joined it, joined random. So Heck You is seated to play against Elvin round one.
Well, maybe.
Yeah, hey guys, no? should I leave it? Guys, should
yes.
I? Hey, I'll let you guys decide. Should I leave Heck You seated like this?
I call this the consequences of your actions.
I'm gonna say leave it, because otherwise I'd have to pick new stream matches, because for some reason this didn't fuck with the seating at all for my purposes.
Okay. Okay, Heck You says, quote, "I don't mind, because if I play in losers, I have to sweat harder and I have to eat and go to bed soon." Okay.
Oh, the classic.
So, alright, so... Let me just look at the bracket again, and based on if I like what I see in the bracket, despite everything, I'll just leave everything as it is. I think I agree with everybody else. This is a suitable punishment for Heki joining late at the 6:45 mark. I think this is a good compromise. Right? Right? I think so. You guys think so?
Sure.
It requires okay. less effort on your part.
Yeah, heck you. Yeah, Elven Shadow, heck you. Yeah, let's see.
Hey, you never know, maybe we'll see another surprise upset against Elven.
You know, hey, you know. Also, if I change the seating, you'd still have to fight somebody else. That's fucked up. I'll leave the seating
Welcome
like this.
Welcome to Plus R.
Yeah, I'll leave the seat.
All the seats suck.
Yeah, I'll leave the seating like this. I'll let him know. Alright, I'm...
Like, actual random seating probably wouldn't actually be resulting the worst possible. In fact, the worst possible probably isn't even that worst possible.
It wouldn't even be that different from what we see anyway. I mean, we already have, like... I mean, Elven Shadow and Hekyu is like a top 8 match already, right?
Yeah, basically. Alright, so I let him know that the seating is going to stay as is. The seating is going to stay as is. Hekyu signed up at 6:45. I'm going to add that to the rules, right? I'll add that to the rules. If you sign up at 6:45 exactly, I'm not seating you. Right? That'll be our concession, I think. If it's 6:45 exactly, I'm not seating you. 6:46, you're not getting in. 6:44 and between 6 o'clock to 6:44, you're getting the eyes emoji. Right? I think that's what we've established.
Sure.
Yeah. That's our
rules. Let it be written, so let it be done.
Yeah, that's our rules now. I hope you guys are happy with this. All right, so I'll start bracket also. Well, start bracket, quote unquote, so that way you can pick the stream matches.
Yee, okay.
Otherwise, I'll do some more tooling around, but I think we're mostly good to go. We'll just start when the actual bracket starts. Fine. Anyway, I hope everyone is doing well. Fine. Yeah, everyone is really surprised that the bracket is really large. I will say this: thank you guys for keeping the bracket growing. We have 31 entrants tonight. This is the largest it's been since we took over WNF. So, you guys are dope. Yeah, that's also true.
Some of that is, you know. Feeling a little bit of the last week being off, so
yeah,
a bit
that's
of a,
yeah, I'm
a
sure.
Th- there.
Yeah, I'm wondering
yeah,
if that's
as much guilty gear this week.
Yeah,
that's why we should increase it to best of five.
Oh boy, the thing that everyone is gonna bully you for is picking all the mirror matches in round one. And then,
I mean, people already do that. Zero makes a joke about it every week in Strat.
Yeah, and so you endure that, but I have to endure the fucking, the thing that Hirsch won't let me live down. Alright, let me make sure that I have Smash GG open to the right everything. Yesterday we had a, Smash GG is just not loading. Excellent.
Yeah, it's not letting me, designate stream matches yet. There's, like, a timer counting down.
Okay.
I guess you just hit it to start at 7 or whatever. That makes sense.
Well, you should be able to choose them ahead of time. I don't know why. Who did you want? Let me try it. Tell me who you wanted round one.
I get T-Spin, Formal Eli, and then Omega Tom Hanks and Wagner.
Okay, I'll try to get the T-Spin match. Okay, for me it worked. It just worked right away. I don't know why it didn't do that. That's odd.
Huh.
And then Wagner.
It's not like giving me the UI to do the quick report or anything either.
Yeah. I mean, it took me a... Wait, are you looking at it in admin view?
Should be. Oh, maybe I'm not.
Yeah.
Let me see. Let me make sure. The website.
I was making that mistake earlier.
Oh yeah, okay, here we go.
Okay. I'll let you try it on the Tom Wagner one then.
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, cool.
That was the issue.
Alright, so we're good. So let me just open everything now. Let's see if moment of truth. Gameplay? Where's gameplay? Hello? If OBS is the last thing that fucks up, I'm gonna be so mad.
Is OBS cut as a website? Have we had this discussion before?
It might. One moment here, gang. Hopefully OBS doesn't, Oh, jeez.
Part of OBS specifically, the browser source definitely is a website.
That's true.
Oh Jesus! Okay, there we go. Hey, did did I just cut out completely? That was on Twitch's end.
What the fuck?
Oh boy! All right.
Yesterday it's Steam. Today it's Twitch.
Oh, goodness gracious.
Something.
Well, we'll try to get it going. Right now, my kilobits per second is in the triple digits. Hopefully it... Okay, no, it's rising. It's rising. I don't know what happened there. That was deeply concerning. Okay. Anyway, good evening, everybody. It is now 7:01 p.m. on the West Coast, Pacific Standard Time. I'm Light the Iron Man. I am joined once again by my co-admin, Kimberly.
Hello.
And my co-commentator, TuxDev.
Hey.
And we are... Hopefully everything works. This is a great thing to start off with as soon as we begin the bracket. Everything works and we can get started with the first Feliz Jueves of the new year. As always, you guys have been doing really great at increasing turnout. We have not been doing anything other than the promotional material that we've always been doing, which is just me tweeting constantly about this. And you guys brought out 31 entrants. I'm assuming a lot of you guys are raring to go for Frosty. So that's really cool of you. Where else are you going to practice for the next major, offline plus R event than the strongest, showing online that we ever get in this bracket? Like, 31 players and more than half of them are top 8 material, and they're all gonna beat the shit out of each other. Also worth noting is that we don't have a bounty this week because Joe Biden stopped the bounty from occurring. So if Joe Biden wins this week again for the second week in a row, there will be a bounty on I can't say this.
Yeah, we're gonna get put on a fucking list, dude. Careful how you're phrasing this.
If the video game player known as Joe Biden wins this bracket for the
who
second
is in
week
fact
game,
the real president of the United States.
No. there will be a fictional low stakes bounty placed on the player should he win the second time in a row? And if someone defeats the president of the United States in our bracket, they will be able to collect the bounty, which is a piece of art drawn by Kim, which is here. Hopefully OBS doesn't crap out on me when I pull this out, but it looks something like looks a little something like this. Here. So if Joe Biden wins the second week in a row and then someone beats him up next week, then there will be the opportunity to win artwork that looks kind of like this. It's really good. Kim's a very talented pixel artist, and you will be able to earn that if you want. anyway, we're gonna just jump right in so that I don't get shut down by the fucking cops for advocating. I need that skit from The Whitest Kids You Know on hand, where they, like, talk about how it's illegal to say, I want to kill the president of the United States. But in the meantime, we're gonna get T-Spin and Formal Eli on here. Get the lobby link again. Eastman's already here. Yeah, so both of these players are regulars.
Mm-hmm. So Kim.
Shit! Oh no! I knew T-Spin was a post. I didn't realize Eli was too. God damn it!
Yeah. So
this is the curse.
Yeah. So once again, our producer has put on the mirror. What? We said this was gonna happen. So anyway, so. So this will be really fun. So we're out here playing Mario Party in round one.
A swim Mario Party. It would be funny if a Mario Party had that swim.
Yeah.
I think there should be a guilty party. I think that'd be good.
That would be kind of cool.
Let me,
Well, I feel like Oxus has done things that are more casual like that, and it really hasn't gone well for them.
That is unfortunate.
Yeah, like Isuka and the Guilty Gear DS game.
Yeah. The game room at the local city college had Isuka, and I was like really disappointed. Like, yes, Guilty Gear. Oh.
Alright, yeah, so T-Spin looks like he's got his shit together here. Bomb head pressure. Okay, that is very nasty. Yeah, this is just very goofy. Is Newt here too? How many Fausts do we have in bracket tonight?
Oh, like at least four.
Yeah, four. Yeah, four. We have T-Spin, formerly
and
Eli,
then like
Newt,
good old
Elvin. Right. Yeah.
These two. Maybe there's another one somewhere.
There might be one
that
we're
forgetting.
There might be one that we're forgetting. Last week was all the ABBAs. Oh no, it's still all the ABBAs. Fuck you guys.
It's always gonna be all the ABBAs. And all the fouls.
Alright,
when are we gonna get All This Little Week back? I like All This Little Week.
yeah, Flack and, there's still a lot of souls. We got Luke and, yeah, that's fine.
Well, T-Spin got that game with a nice perfect.
Alright, so we get,
Media?
Yeah, we're poking. Yeah, where were they? That took a long time to throw, I think. Alright, we got the candy. Alright. Alright, right now T-Spin's looking like he's not getting like the items that he wants. Colin, there was there were weeks where Hanno and Tipme were both playing. Tipme's in the bracket tonight. So you could have entered and made it two cliffs. That would have been really upsetting.
All that Orochin Jima.
No one's gonna get that! We were talking last night about how all we do on commentary is make shitty non-sequitur jokes. No one's gonna get these jokes that we're making about Umi and Echo. We have to commentate the Faust match. We have to commentate the Faust match. Alright. Formerly Eli.
Very close.
Yeah.
Command.
He still has burst. He can get out if he needs to.
Both.
Oh! Okay. Not. Yeah. The Pogo's dive kick is very interesting there.
Yeah. Busts are going my way.
Thank you, Jack, for the host. We were actually just talking about you before Braga started.
I also noticed that Jack named Mon Eugene. I'm not sure if it's related or not. I hope it is.
Alright.
It was muted at the time, so I don't really know.
Okay. I mean, these... You know, realistically speaking, these guys are just playing, like, the ultimate Faust neutral. They're just kind of
really
hopping
is.
Around each other, throwing items, throwing heads. Alright, yeah. Gets KO'd by the meteors. That really could have gone in Formal Eli's way.
Oh yeah, it was really like, close those last two rounds.
Yeah, like literally.
It was definitely like adapting to stuff, just not quite enough.
All right, so that was a really good round. This is another. This is going to be another like really strong one where you get Tom Hanks versus Wagner on here. Like Tom Hanks FL. I need to re-justify the. Okay, even with the left justify, it's not moving. That's fine. The Florida will just be off-screen, that's fine. And then a Wagner. So this will be interesting. So we'll get Potemkin. I keep forgetting who Wagner plays, even though I've seen them all the time. I'm pretty sure I've played against him, too. So, Omega. Von Hanks versus Wagner. Hopefully they're here. Let me move the player name here. Oh, so then we do have a bunch of ABBAs in Braga tonight, then. You guys are nasty.
Perfect.
It's very funny that the, you know, for all the character variety in this game, WNF specifically sees a lot of, like, repeat matchups and dittos and stuff. It's just funny how that works.
Yeah, who do we actually not see very much?
Ridge?
We haven't seen too much of Zappa, but I think there were
Hellsap is finally coming back, so we're seeing Zappa again. We haven't seen Jacob Pat or any other Bridgets to come back in a while.
Yeah, that's true.
Who else?
Sean is the only one who plays Jam, I think.
Yeah.
And he's a total wild card.
Yeah, he will play like whoever, Viking. Yeah. He would play a completely different character from day to day, yeah.
We haven't seen a Mei for a while.
Yeah.
I see his Mei all the time because he likes to choose violence.
Colin, there are like random slayers, but no one like Vero or Taka or
Technically Sean also has a Slayer.
Yeah.
Technically.
Why does Sean play half the cast? Still says waiting for ping estimation. Should we remake the room? Let me remake the room.
Hey, Sage plays like literally everyone but Eno.
Yeah, that's true. And then we finally started seeing Eno when Tommy Gun came through.
Yeah.
All right, I'll remake the room really quickly, just to see what's going on. I don't know. Hopefully, it's just on Wagner's end and not ours. But.
Oh shit! It looks like Hecky managed to survive.
Survive. Nice.
Wow. Man. Okay, so
I'm very impressed.
Yeah. So Hecky. Okay, so
we threw Hecky with the Rancor and just killed it.
Yeah. So for those of you who may have missed it while we were describing this during setup, we intentionally seeded Hecky against Elven Shadow in round one because he registered at the last possible moment.
And by intentionally seeded, we more like intentionally neglected to fix.
Yeah. And it looks like it worked out in his favor anyway, off stream. Okay, so they're both back in here. It looks like this is... Okay, there we go. So that fixed it. All right.
I want to hear nothing from Hecky about seeding from ever on forward.
Yeah, he doesn't get to complain anymore. Did E2 Deku and Lurking play?
I have
no
idea.
You know who we haven't seen, like, at all? Eddie.
Yeah, true.
Yeah, that's true. That's a good one.
I'm still a little bit... I will continue to be a little bit, traumatized by, XX Eddie, Vanilla XX.
Yeah. Still being a pain. Okay, it looks like there's some... It worked eventually in the other lobby as soon as I left. Oh my goodness. I will restart the whole game. How's that sound? I need to be able to capture this. If it still doesn't work after this, then we'll just have you guys play off stream, and then we'll move on to like a round two match or something. But, that's very goofy. I don't know why it's doing this now, of all nights.
What a mysterious game.
All right. Hussar. There we go. Let me restart the Discord stream. The room again. Link again. Whoops. All right. One more time. I'm gonna post the link again. I think it's actually the same link every time.
I think it's like some player ID thing in there.
And if this doesn't work, then we'll just, then I'll just move on.
I think
to
Steam has this fundamental assumption somewhere in there that you only play one game at a time.
Yeah. So it just creates the same room code over and over. Hopefully for realsies. I'm assuming by the fact that it's, need forever to start. Okay.
So what happens if you leave the loop and then come back in for
while
mine?
It's going on? While it's going on? Yeah, hang
no,
on.
No, not while it goes on, but while... But, since apparently it worked when you left the room, you just leave the room.
Yeah,
and then
you know
come
what?
Back in
hang on. What? Yeah, let me join. This is so jank. This is so jank.
Go to your xxaxencore+r website.
I actually.
Actually, no, it's
Wagner
not. Because there's
maybe
no technology.
An issue with Wagner?
Maybe, I don't know. Well,
Universal Will doesn't work.
If it's still not working, we'll just have them play off stream, and they can just figure it out, and then we'll move on to round two after. And I also have to. This also gives me some time to correct some Smash UG stuff because it looks like Newt and Fiji forgot to check in, and so it says that Newt got DQ'd. So I have to edit that really quickly. Alright, so we'll have you guys, so we'll have Wagner and Tom play it out off stream. I won't call, I'm not gonna call round two yet because there's still a lot of other stuff that we have to sort out. This is the first time this has happened, like, especially this severely with plus R.
Usually behaves better, which is amusing since it is the original beta game at this.
Yeah, basically.
Given the latest like surge.
Alright, so bracket should be fixed, now at least. Are there any other matches still going in round two besides the one that we're trying to get played right now? Okay, it looks like Jason Riot just got done too. Anyway, thank you guys for your patience as we try to sort this out. Obviously, there's some things that are just out of our hands. Let me remake the lobby again before I forget. Oh boy. Okay. Now let's get. Let me manually start round two. Going. All right. Alright, and in the meantime, we'll get Naj and Cyan on here. And hopefully, this game still isn't broken.
I mean, it is. Naj is going to be playing.
Yeah, Naj is going to prove to us that the game is literally broken. Meanwhile, going up against Cyan, who I believe this is their first time entering WNF. Yeah, heck you. Round two just started. I just called it.
I'm so used to Smash.gg not letting me mark stream matches that I always, like, I've been forgetting to do it now that it's working.
I would like my local TO to use that feature more often, or actually at all. When the TO desk is literally on the other side of the room, kind of hard to know what's going on over there.
Yeah. Where's Cyan Plaza? They reported their score in the thing.
I talked to them in Discord.
Apparently they're DMing Naj. Okay, there they go. Another foul!
Fuck!
Man. Foul saw the way down.
Okay, so it looks... Okay, well...
That kind of checks out.
Alright, well, it looks like they're able to start playing, so whatever was going on was probably Tom Wagner exclusive. But we're gonna have another Faust. Oh, that's a gaudy looking color.
Ooh.
Ooh.
They're not on the snow stage.
Please.
Mega Faust gives you a migraine.
Yeah. Please be sure, folks, to watch WNF Fleece Weavis in a well lit room and be careful not to sit too close to the screen.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, so Naj doing wow! All right, immediately with the first throw. All right. Okay, bursts. How did he get the angel? He was just mashing. He was mashing heavy slash and got the angel.
Yeah.
Oh man. Yeah, there has to be like a better blue Faust that you can pick, right?
There has to be.
Like,
I mean, I assume it's intentional.
Like, you're playing this kind of color, it's super intentional.
Yeah, there has to be.
This is like the lime green and pink scout.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, you can't even tell that. You can't even tell he's poisoned.
Yeah. Unfortunately for him, we're not on
London. This is like slight flash of purple, but like it's so subtle. Yeah.
All right, dive kick going my way to get out of the corner. We're just kind of slip and sliding around Exit Beast on the ground. Oh, good throw on the
dust.
Going
to 5D, which has strange interval for some reason.
Yeah, I don't know why 5D is like a pseudo reversal. Notch takes game one.
I tried to 6H of 5D and it didn't work and I was not happy. Heaven or hell, do one, let's rock.
Alright, another good throw. Yeah.
Is that like a setup there?
Maybe. He might be going... He did it this time without intending to throw a burst, so he might just be going for it as like a reset or something.
Yeah. Using burst to dodge the flower is kind of amusing.
Alright, gotta avoid the webs. Okay, using the head to disable the webs. Yeah. I will say, like... Cyan is just getting hit by different in other fucked up Testament shenanigans, but he's like or they're doing like a good job at like staying in the air and kind of avoiding all the shit that would happen on the ground, like executing tree and stuff.
Oh yeah, yeah. And I am kind of wondering about all this like crazy usage of wands.
Yeah.
Like every other move is wand, or was anyway. This time he hasn't been using wands that much.
Yeah. I guess there's nothing to parry. Or nothing that he's worried about parrying. Or like, he doesn't really feel like maybe he needs to use that to move or cross up.
Yeah, like, I was seeing him using it as, like, a movement tool.
Yeah.
Kind of like that one.
Yeah, like, right there. Warrant into, like, going right underneath Faust and then getting the air for to close out the set.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was really good. Alright, so Naj moves on to Winner's Quarters.
Maybe Faust just, like, doesn't have a particularly good answer to it compared to, like, other characters.
Yeah. Well, then, in the meantime, after that, we'll get Stone and Tipme on here. So, this will be Johnny and Cliff. So, the two swordsmen. This is not a matchup that we've seen on here. We've seen both of these characters, we've seen both of these players, but we have not seen this matchup. So, this will be very exciting. Fingers crossed nothing breaks. Berserk 2016 Joyer.
Oh boy.
I'm so mad. Why would you say that? You say that to make me mad, I think.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
Oh,
it worked.
Man. Yeah. Fucking guess.
It's a Cliff player. What do you expect?
I mean, I expect a Cliff player to be a Berserk fan, but not a fan of the CG anime where the like, guts is just like being drag and dropped across the screen. Anyway, we'll see if Stone can handle this. Looks like he's doing a very good job at staying overhead, using Insanga to.
Many coins though.
Yeah. I know that he has a Force Break that gives him Misfinder stacks anyway, but yeah, he's spent all his coins. Okay. It might not... Well, it doesn't probably doesn't matter now, yeah.
No,
He worked his way in and out.
Really good Johnny buttons.
Yeah. I was not paying attention to Tiffany's health bar. I was just like, oh... I was just paying attention to the Johnny resource, so I was like, oh, this is unfortunate. But I was like, oh, he used
but
all
also,
that well.
Also, Cliff is an old man that does not have much health. It doesn't matter, though, if Johnny can't actually, you know, get hit in, like, at all.
Yeah, very narrowly stopping the perfect. Okay. Oh, he got the 5D anyway, so that looked really goofy. All right, even round count.
Yeah, no tension at that point would be rough. I did not realize that Cliff can be an astronaut.
Yeah. We're joining the Anderson space program.
Yeah, like that's usually like Chip or Bridget.
More like Overson. Don't laugh at that.
Anyway, Stone takes game one. All Alright, more corner pressure.
Nice misfire combo. Bring another coin. Still got tons of meat to work with, but wasted on a whiff the what's my name.
Okay, I guess he couldn't do anything about, like, what was going on when Stone was so high up above throwing out overheads.
Yeah, and Senga, real good.
I like that they gave Senga to Mei in Exert. I think that's just really
it's
funny.
It's so cool.
Yeah.
And also ridiculous. I do not like getting hit by Senga from Mei, because, I die shortly thereafter to, corner pressure.
Is he gonna die? Okay, yeah.
Yes.
This is wild.
Dodge the, 6H. Does, like, a lot of chip, actually.
Okay. The big fucking misfinder. Guess I started with the miss again. Oh, but gets parried! The spot dodged, rather.
Yeah.
Look at that risk gauge, too! Cliff gets big fucking damage.
Look at
too.
That red ball.
Yeah.
That's some nice stuff.
Yeah. Dive kick. Another good spot. He keeps doing that though.
That's
backspin.
It.
Like. Yeah.
Only takes the one. Needs the one hit.
Yeah. Yeah. That was like a matter of, you know, distance and. And, you know, just only needing the one confirm. Even though, like, Tip Me was able to rack up the damage on block, on hit.
Yeah, that whiff the sweep was brutal after the dodge.
Alright, so we have... Okay, so we do have Winter's Quarters ready. So, without any hiccups, which is good. So, I will get that started in a bit, making sure there's no, discrepancies. Anywhere else? Okay, yeah, I have to reset someone's result because they once again forgot to check in.
Yeah, I'm taking a look at that.
Alright. Alright, in the meantime. Oh, in the meantime, it looks like Jason's already here. He's very, very eager to fight Naj, I guess. Alright. Don't start just yet when you guys get in here. Because I haven't even called Winter's Quarters yet.
Hey, folks, don't forget to check in.
Yeah, please don't...
We can fix it, but check it.
Yeah. Alright, so I'll let you guys go get started now that you're both in here, and I am officially calling, Winter's Quarters. So we'll get Jason Ryan versus Naj. I feel like we've actually made it so that these two don't actually play each other that often until they get to top 8, but they're playing each other
really.
A little bit earlier here, so... Also, yes, thank you for reminding me. Be sure to check out the Match Reno. Use those codes. Alright, so we've got Jason Ryan and Naj. So, obviously, Naj is a very strong Testament player, best of the best. But Jason Ryan has been on a tear. So, although, Jason Ryan the blood has been let from him. Yeah. Yeah, he has been cut open by a bunch of people over the past couple of WNFs, so... We'll see what happens. Looks like Naj is getting it to work.
Doing a pretty good job, yeah.
Yeah.
Jace has not really had the opportunity to do any sidewinders against the like most sidewinderable character in the cast.
The biggest knockdown that he got there was just like a regular throw. Alright, here we go. We're gonna get something started here. Okay, it gets punished on the back dash.
There we go. Yeah. There's the sidewinder. And that's it. All it took was just...
He needed like...
three combos.
Yeah, basically. Just two or three very clean confirms. And that's all he needed. Oh my god. That's already 50% done.
Yeah.
Okay.
Bust. Punished with another four sidewinders. Or three this time.
Oh my goodness.
There's the spawn.
I think this happens once a bracket.
Oh, he wanted to involve the Nightmare Circular with Time Wave. I know it. Because that's, you know...
That's what you would do? Is that what you would do? Oh my god. Alright, so Jason Riot takes it. The Naj's only mistake was letting Jason Riot touch him. Like, really.
Yeah.
And, like, even then, like... Oh, man. Alright, so we'll see how this goes. I mean, Naj can easily take control of it, as we saw early in the round one of the last game. So we'll see how this goes. But Jason Riot manages to get through its curtains. Alright, Exit Beast. Burst. It doesn't quite bait the burst, but... Alright, one, two... Yeah, cash out on
it, with the force pick, so it wasn't the biggest damage. Oh, he VV'd through it! Oh yeah, just this run-up DP, stupid nonsense.
if not the most privileged Dragon Punches of all Final Games.
Didn't get the clean hit on that Grand Viper.
Alright, Exit Beast. Yeah, Naj is playing very patiently now. He knows that like he has to actually kind of be a little bit careful. Okay, those trees and webs are all gone. Alright, Warren. Oh, but we're gonna throw the cross up.
Misses the conversion off the wild throw, though.
Yeah, uncharacteristic drop. But we take those, right? Naj is definitely gonna run with that. Oh, he probably wanted a combo there. He probably knew that the key would push him into the web, but he didn't make it in time. Not enough burst. Oh no! Gets punished on the backdash again! Jason didn't believe in it though. Alright, Exit Beast.
I was gonna go 60 but went low instead.
Oh, the drop!
So
another
close.
Drop! Okay.
Just one more.
Oh, touch. Gold Burst!
Okay, Gold Burst!
Okay. Yeah, if you were going to Gold Burst there, that would've... Oh, no! Wasn't FD!
Dude, FD the Gunflame!
Oh, no! He's probably up backing or something, and he got hit during pre-jump or something. I don't know.
Maybe.
Yeah. Oh, that was really close. But the... I mean, it was 2-0, but it was a close 2-0. Alright, so Jason takes it and moves on to Winter Semis, where he'll have to face winner of Hecky versus Omega Tom Hanks. I believe that's the Florida Classic. And then, in the meantime, we'll get 8-Man versus Dude the Week. So we'll have another Fast on here.
Apparently Nas tried to slash back the gun flame. That is,
Oh, that's very bold.
That is ambitious.
That is very, very bold.
Hey, folks, don't forget to check in. I just had to, like, reset, like, three separate matches because yeah. People forgot to check in.
Yeah, I'm watching you do that in real time. Alright, so in the meantime, we've got the 8-Man. Oh, looks like it's another Johnny. That's rare to have more than one Johnny in a plus R bracket. It's not. This is
Johnny Faust.
Yeah.
It's always Faust.
Always Faust.
Today it's.
There's like, what, six Fausts in here?
Yeah.
Is that what
Oops, all Fausts! Alright.
Good thing they fixed the randomizer bug.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm glad that our lobby breaks for like weird and indiscriminate reasons rather than for Faust reasons now.
Yeah.
All right, so this will be a very interesting match to watch. All right, Bond Bag. So, I want to point out Newt is usually like one of the stronger like Fausts that we will see, but like one of the most significant matches that he's had on stream here was like. He got completely screwed over by Item Toss, and then he, like, which was, like, super unfortunate, but, like, usually Newt the Boot is, like, very, very strong and consistent. Yeah, very good dive kick going my way to close out round one, avoiding Johnny pressure.
Rushes right underneath the coin.
Alright, command dash into throw. Okay, but no knockdown off of it. I like the cheeky air to air though, to stop the falling pogo. Alright, has to burst there. Donnie has spent a lot of his coins now too. Still has burst and a lot of meter on deck, so he can still build alright.
But he need like one coin or two coins.
Yeah.
Get the good stuff going.
Yeah, this could be it, in fact.
Oh, yeah.
Especially with that meter. Oh, the drop!
This is the what's your name?
Yeah. Okay. Alright, yeah. Not much Newt could do there with no resources. Alright, full screen pokes.
Point
is so busted. Alright. Pogo combos. That item was that meters? I didn't actually see what that was. I think it just went off screen.
Yeah, it just went off screen.
Yeah. Unfortunately that he couldn't take advantage of that. Alright, A-Man playing Foozies. Oh, gets his combo interrupted by the wash pan, but doesn't care. Newt spends burst in a really uncomfortable wet manner. Oh, force break pogo. What could these be? Oh, no!
It was a swell in your face. That,
yeah.
That's what it was.
One frame, like one frame late or early on either side. And Newt probably would have had that, but 8-Man takes it. Alright, just gonna run up and smack him. Yeah, this is another instance of Newt getting boned by his own RNG, which is funny. It's tragic, but it's funny. You know, Smash players have been trying to ban Hero because of the RNG element involved. And
well, they're also Smash players.
Yeah. But whenever I see those arguments, because I still follow Smash players on Twitter, I always think about Faust. And I think about and I think about how much Faust has to play by Faust or Famine. And yeah.
See, what Smash players really should do is just play with Iamb like it's supposed to be played.
Alright, we're in the corner. Newt is defending very well.
Each punch is really good.
Yeah. Oh, Robokai! Okay, but this gets blocked. Alright, good pokes.
And Senga, one more hit!
Oh no! Okay, can we get something here?
The throw went through the bomb explosion.
Dead angle. Oh, okay. And we're gonna get tech thrown. Yeah.
With no resources left. Perfect game.
Yeah. Alright, so this is a game 3, 8 man's on set point, but we could see how this goes.
It's like you're playing like a tempo deck in Magic and end the game with no cards in hand.
Alright, we got a bunch of these little minis helping keep pressure going. Alright, going my way combo, knockdown. This should be it.
One more hit, but anything can happen.
Yeah.
Hashiman has all the resources,
there we go.
But the...
Alright. Newt puts a game on the board.
Does it.
Yeah. I'm
much full screen.
Yeah. Basically. I'll be completely transparent in saying that I want Newt to win mostly because I want him to run it back against make it back up in the way that he couldn't do before last time he was on stream. Alright, so we've got typical Johnny pressure coming out again. Alright, Newt is trying to keep away, trying to increase his hang time by throwing air bomb bag air item. Alright, we're going fishing.
A might.
Yeah, good knockdown with that meter. Ooh, good double overhead. Burst gets caught by the pogo flower.
Doing the comeback.
Yeah.
Now it's even in health, but...
Oh! Okay, so you're gonna... Yeah. Oh, no! Oh, that's a Domi Burst. Or that's a... Well, that's a... Well, it's a Domi Burst and a Cali Burst. Alright, so... A-Man once again on set point.
Real well this round.
Yeah. Really stylish combos there.
Need
oh
just,
no!
Like, one more hit here.
Yeah.
There we
wow.
go.
He would not let Newt land. That
not
was
at all.
That was genuinely impressive there. Like, I think we were watching Stone earlier having a hard time anti-airing. But like, I mean obviously a different matchup, but like I thought maybe but like he did not have a difficult time at all, like locking Newt out from the movement.
Upcoin was so clutch there.
Yeah, so 8-man moves on 2-1 over Newt. there's gonna be a hell of a loser's run for everybody involved here.
Yeah, it looks like a pretty scary loser's bracket right now.
Yeah, so we've got... We're still not quite there yet, because I guess we're still waiting on some matches, but we've got people like Stone waiting to maybe play against Newt, and then like Naj and Hekyu. This is the first like week that we've gotten that we won't see Naj Stone, because I made sure to seed that properly. So while we wait for loser side to catch up, we are going to be at this is now in winter semis, so we are starting top 8. So we will see. I think we'll see Tom and Hecky. No, wait. Yeah. Tom Hanks and Jason Ryan. We'll see them first.
And Soul. I do not like playing against Pot. I feel like pretty much all my specials are locked out, which is probably not bad for me as a player, but
yeah.
Is a little frustrating.
Let's get those two in here. I don't remember how often these two have played in this bracket. Let alone Jason playing a Pot. So, I don't know. Likewise,
Jason played Pot before, but it's been a while.
Yeah. Likewise, I don't know how much Tom likes this matchup. If he does.
Yeah, the thing Soul has that can make Pot very sad, but yeah. The fun experience of seeing a Grand Viper and getting Pot busted anyway.
Yeah. Oh man. Alright, so here we go. They side switched on me. I think this is the first time it's happened tonight. Heaven or hell? Duel. One. Let's rock. Oh my goodness.
Just runs up with the wild throw.
Oh, but the second sidewinder whiffs!
Who's the wheel grappler of this game?
I guess it's fucking Jason Riot. Not even Soul, just like the dude. Oh, whiffs the burst.
Yeah,
Jason Riot has a command grab in real life.
Yeah, he does.
Okay.
Alright.
Three dust into two sidewinders? Okay, the third one was not clean hit.
This is what we'll see though. Hot is combo food. So like...
Yeah.
That worked even without...
Grand Viper! No clean hits, though.
Okay, run up DPRC. Whiffs Pot Buster. Gets hit through the Gigantrakai.
Does a 5-H through the shield.
Okay, OTG takes
OTG
the round
2K,
one.
OTG 2K, yeah.
This is tough. Yeah, so, like, Tom will end this in one good confirm, but...
Right.
He's gonna get, like, smacked around like a big-ass ping-pong ball until he gets that opening. Like, these IED backs are really putting in a lot of work for Jason's defense. Alright, jumping over Gun Flames. Blocking Grand Viper correctly this time. Gets punished on both the backdash and the dead angle attempts. And Jason takes game one.
Getting very good payoff from his tension use.
Yeah. Making use of his meter really well.
Yeah.
Heaven or hell? Do a one. Let's rock.
All right, so we'll see this again. Okay, we're getting like these good like short combos.
Right.
Because he wants to condition Jason into eventually blocking so that he can run his grappler mix.
Problem. Why block when you can just push JP?
Oh no! Oh, that was a really risky dead angle. I felt like that could have been punished. Okay. No flicks on the. Can you flick Gunflame? You should be able to flick Gunflame, right?
Well, you can flick Gunflame.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. No flicks on Gunflame.
Have fun.
Okay, I tried to flick whatever was going on there, but gets hit by Burst instead.
Got a clean hit that time.
Yeah. Around the world?
Sidewind does.
Another one? Okay. Yeah, we went kind of, sort of, corner to corner. Not really. We went, like, corner to screen corner. But... Okay. Oh, he wanted something else there. He fucked up his IAD, but it doesn't matter. He was able to continue his pressure.
Yeah, JP.
Full dust loop.
Such a good content. Now, okay. Yeah. Mega had all the resources there, but could not spend it.
Yeah, he didn't get his reversal. He probably wanted a reversal and just didn't get it or something. He had also realized probably maybe that like dead angle wasn't working the way he wanted it to. So
yeah,
getting blown up off of that.
The air pushes have been working pretty well. Jason.
Yeah. Man. I guess the Jason Wright combo exhibition is over. And he moves on to winner's side of finals. With a very clean 2-0. Finishing with a perfect.
I think it was a very clean perfect.
Yeah. Yeah, we're seeing a lot of instances where people that we have seen on stream are finally playing each other for the first time. Or, at least first time here. Or at least first time on our stream. And, they're showing, you know, like, what these matchups look like. So Jason moves on, and then on the other side of Winter's side, we have 8-Man and Skeletal. So this will be Johnny Alba, which is another matchup that we don't see a lot. I don't know if Stone has played however many Abbas in this bracket.
I feel like Stone Skeletal is common enough. I mean, we have so many Abbas in WNF.
Yeah, that's also true. You're bound to run into, like, Heck You or Solidified or...
yeah.
Or, obviously, Skeletal at some point. So, that's true. So... We'll see how 8-Man does against the ABBA, right?
Yeah.
You know something? I was looking at a... Because you know how there are, like, tier lists, but then there's also, like graphs that show, like, how easy a character is to pick up?
Yeah.
I was looking at one of those for Plus R, and it said that ABBA is, like... If S tier is like the easiest character to play in the game, then ABBA is apparently very beginner friendly. Just according to that list. And I never really thought about it that way, but I guess ABBA has
I think there's a different tier list that is more appropriate for beginner friendliness.
Yeah,
and Pop ranks very high on that one.
Yeah. There was also that, I don't know if you guys saw this, but there was that tier list that the kids made, where they were playing.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Tier list when we're talking beginners.
Yeah, there was a tier list that those kids made, and Pot was very high, because they weren't, like, doing throws, they were,
It was just big, giant buttons. Just big, punching, giant buttons, and sometimes doing Hammerfall, because apparently charge moves was what they figured out. Not motions, charge.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess that's easier for like people with like lower dexterity, maybe. It's probably just easier for them to figure out and just like wait and then do the motion or something.
My dexterity is you know how it is.
Yeah, I hear it. I hear it violently whenever we're playing together on call, Tux. Yeah.
And charge moves do not click with me at all.
Well, I mean, you and I are handshake emoji on that front.
Yeah.
I don't like playing Charger. Anyway, so we got 8 man here. Alright, Skeletal is immediately getting his strip together. Alright, we're dealing with all of the Abba pressure. Okay, up backing didn't work actually because. Yeah. Yeah, it's so humbling to see NSYNC putting in so much work in all the matches that 8 man has played on stream until now because of Danzai.
Danzai.
Yeah. So, Skeletal takes round
What's
one very...
What's more privilege, Danzai or Volcanic Viper?
Yeah, very handily. No, that's a good question, actually. I feel like... I'll leave that up to chat.
I feel very, very privileged with Volcanic Viper doing what happened on Tuesday.
You know what? I think it might be Danzai because Abba doesn't leave the ground, so she doesn't get punished in the air. But that being said, I feel like Soul doesn't get punished for doing Volcanic Viper and whipping anyway, so fuck you.
3 times?
Yeah, 3 times I tried to close slash that, and then I got fucking hit. So pissed off. Fuck you.
It was HVV even. It wasn't even.
Yeah, you know, it wasn't the slash version. It wasn't the like easier to
Stay
punish one.
Question.
Yeah. Anyway, Skeletal takes game one. Okay, very stylish combo to get into Blood Mode there. Aroha. Okay, does not get the Insega, so it doesn't get the knockdown.
Yeah.
Just pops with.
Johnny has a bit more trouble with knockdown.
Yeah. Goku Danzai just eats burst.
Yeah.
Okay, chat is bringing up some fair
Pretty
points.
Pretty close in health here, though.
Yeah.
If Johnny can get one good hit, maybe, somehow, nope.
Alright, once again, just a quick and dirty Maroha key grab. Oh, we're gonna get the throw? Will Insega connect this time? Yeah. Okay, gets the knockdown.
One more hit. Okay. Uses Goku to reset the Vita.
So he didn't have burst after all, so. Or messed up the throw. Okay. Getting hit by, like, falling buttons and Insega and stuff. But doesn't really matter. Health is low now for Abba, but oh no, gets it back. Yeah, you drank her Capri Sun.
Yeah.
I actually want that to be retcon now.
Lots of meter here to walk with.
Oh, okay. Just gonna sweep the leg. All right, clean 2-0 for Skeletal. There we go. So so now winners finals will be Jason and Skeletal, but it looks like we don't have any matches ready on loser's side yet. so we'll, I guess whenever the first one there is ready, we'll get that going. Just so that you guys know, I mean, you guys can look at the bracket with exclamation mark bracket, but right now on loser's side, we are waiting on Stone and Rumper to finish, Newt and Papple to finish, Naj and Elven Shadow, who
Naj
just got
really
started
on the Faust Gauntlet.
Yeah, no kidding. Yeah. yeah. So Naj and Elven Shadow just started, and then Hekyu and Luke just finished playing, but they have to wait for Heck, you just still has to wait for Naj and Elven Shadow to finish. So, we'll give this a little bit. I don't want to jump into Winners Finals right now, because then that'll be a really jarring. So we'll give it a bit. Thank you guys for your patience while we wait for our loser side to get sorted out.
Click on the Match Arena.
Yeah, while we're here and while we're waiting, be sure to click on the Match Arena. Thank you, Stone, for the raid. I'm guessing by that means that you're... Yeah, because Rumper just
Yes, Rumper got through.
Yeah, so it looks like your run is done. Thank you for playing, and thank you for coming through and for the raid. So we'll wait for... between Naj and Elvin... Alright, between Naj and Elvin and Newt and Papel, who do you think is going to... which set do you think will finish first?
I'm gonna guess Newt because
Newt has been going on for longer, but yeah. Who knows what Smash.GG even means?
That's also true.
Yeah. Well, it's whatever. In the meantime, since we just have a bunch of raiders, and as Kim was pointing out, remember to check out !MatchArena. Fun little statistic: Matcherino in total for WNF alone raised something like $30,800 last year. That includes donations and codes. So hit up the Matcherino, use those codes. There's 60 of you. There's only 30 codes or something. Actually, how many codes are there? In fact, let me go and do the Matcherino. Let me put my mouth where my money is.
I think you might get kicked off of Twitch for doing that on stream.
Well, if I don't get kicked off of Twitch for all the shit about Joe Biden,
that's true.
Then I feel like I'm fine. But yeah, so go and use those Matcherino codes. Looks like Luke contributed a little decent chunk of cash there. So thank you, Luke, for the $10 in direct contribution. Yeah, there's still lots of these codes left on the table. So I can see this counter going up in real time, by the way. Vi suggested to me that I put, like, that I get, like, a plugin where I put, like, the top contributors to Matcherino on the screen. I feel like that's a little bit too involved, but I can see who's contributing to the Matcherino. So thank you guys so much for using these codes. Tip me, just use some. Griffin Cole, just use some. Lord Narkom, who just came through to the stream, just use some. Luke did a direct contribution on top of using the code. Ironmonger, use some. Jason, just use some. Jason, you're going to be earning this money to pay for your next hat. So yes, thank you very much. In the meantime, it looks like Newt and Papel been playing for like two. Oh wait, hang on. Oh, this will be funny because this is the run back.
Oh yeah, that's right! Oh my god, I forgot about that.
Alright, so it looks like Naj Elven Shadow wrapped up first before Newt Papel finished. So we will get
the one back on, yeah.
Yeah, so we'll get the... So for those... Again, I will repeat this because we had a bunch of people come in just now who might not remember the context. So... Heck, you joined the bracket at the very last possible second to sign up.
Literally,
he joined the bracket at 6:45 p.m., which is my personal cutoff for late entrance. Why is Heck, you at 276 ping? What is that? What's going on
busy
there?
Busy enough for reasons.
Oh, goodness.
Right? Maybe? Reasons.
Yeah, I... Anyway, so as I was saying, so Heck, you joined the bracket late, which means that he was last seed, and because he was last seed, that meant that he was seeded to fight Elven Shadow round one, and as punishment for him joining the bracket late. I let that seeding rock. And because, and so he played Hekyu, so Hekyu and Elven Shadow played each other in round one, and Hekyu won. So Hekyu put Elven Shadow and losers in round one. So this is actually the run back in losers side of top eight.
Yep.
So, however long this takes for them to get set up, I can see that the match is trying to start, but Hekyu is, exploding.
Dodging.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know if Hekyu, had his mom kick the router over or something, but... Alright, so it looks like we're getting started here. Alright, so Hekyu, the White Void, not playing White Abba this week. Alright. I'm assuming that this is basically what the round one set looked like. That we didn't get to see.
Gets the hidden and nice big damage! Good big Abba damage.
Yeah. Alright, staying
Goku
in.
There.
Yeah, he's gonna have to stay in.
Below opens him up.
Oh, the air throw on the dive kick. Wow.
One more hit.
Yeah, looks like Hekyu has Elvin's number. You know, like, Elvin usually does really well against Skeletal, right? But
yeah.
I guess it's just a matter of playstyle. Alright, so here we go. Okay, now this is the Elvin Shadow we've come to love, right? Blocks the key grab. Back into the corner with you.
Gets the scalpel. Working on this perfect.
Alright, once again. Yeah, Hekyu still hasn't spent burst.
Doesn't want to spend burst on this round.
Yeah, so Elvin evens it up very nicely. Reminding everybody that he's Elven Shadow. But Hekyu is out here to remind everybody that he's Hekyu. Oh, gets thrown. That's one knockdown. He will burst soon if he gets another knockdown. Yeah, there we go. Yeah.
Beats that knockdown. Uses Goku
okay,
to
Goku.
Reset.
But gets hit out of the Goku activation. Has
okay,
burst.
There's the bus to escape the pogo.
Oh, but then gets crossed up.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, Elvin looking to avenge himself. Oh, so Newt Papple was a Faust mirror, so that's like six or seven total Fausts, so that's what...
Yeah.
In retrospect, that's so funny. Alright, so Hekyu starting off very strongly again. Building up a lot of risk on Elvin. Not intimidated by items this time. Air throw to put him back into the corner. Crosses up going my way. Oh, but did not see Robokai there. I didn't see him either. Not letting himself get poked by Scalpel. All right.
Oh. Opened up a bit. The gold bust.
Okay. Spends FRC on exiting safely. Although Elvin probably couldn't punish anyway since he was so high.
But now, no resources and...
Yeah.
In not a great mode.
Yeah. Alright, Elvin on set point here. Okay, jumping over everything. Okay. Oh, just getting juggled by these pogo shenanigans. Elvin really likes that stance. Okay, Heki doesn't have many other options here. Oh, man. Unless... Okay. Goku? Like, immediate Goku. We're not going to waste any time. Oh, but... Okay. And then if the meteors didn't... if that didn't kill him, then the meteors would have.
Yeah.
So, alright. So Elvin takes it. Getting the run back against Heki who put him here in the first place. Reminding everybody who he is, what he does, what event he runs. Obviously practicing, using my tournament to practice to win his own event. Very admirable of him. Heki you in the Discord says, "No, who R sees that? You're so weird." I really, really enjoy watching the players, like, chat it out after. Because I don't think the Strive players do that often. there's a really great level of familiarity that we get in the Plus R, with the Plus R chat whenever you guys come through.
The Strive players are, like, on public transit with each other, you know?
Yeah. And all the Plus R players are in my house. That's the attitude. Alright, so, so now we'll have Rumper versus Newt. But we'll have another Faust.
And before this is another Faust mirror?
No, we got Rebukai. Rebukai,
oh,
I think
oh,
is
shit,
the,
okay.
Yeah. So here we go. So this is one of the first times we've seen a Rebukai on here.
Yeah, I think we saw, who was it, Akito base?
Yeah.
A couple times?
Yeah, but not often enough.
Yeah, not recently.
Yeah.
I always get Akito base and Josuke mixed up because they both play Soul and Strive.
Yeah. Same. I have also said that before. I thought that Akito was, because Akito, I think Akito also plays Soul and Exert. If I'm remembering correctly. Alright, so, we've got, Rebukai. This is gonna be really goofy. This is this is a cartoon character matchup. So we've got Rebukai.
Is this a canon match?
Maybe.
I don't remember if they really, like, interacted, like, with each other that much. I feel like they really haven't.
Yeah. Alright, so, so Rebukai managing a really goofy-ass meter, getting the good halves of all of Kai's moves. and then there's Newt. Who, again, I'm rooting for Newt if only because, for whatever reason, WNF RNG... Like, WNF screws up for his RNG. So, out of guilt, I root for Newt. But it looks like...
the paper fan gets it done.
Yeah. Alright, the good half of Stun Dipper. Why do you have that?
He needs it. Robo Fortune has it, too.
Yeah.
Which is pretty funny.
Okay, so explodes, and then Newt gets to run his shit now. Alright. Blocking... Okay, whips a karate chop, but doesn't matter. And it looks like Rumper's about to explode.
Delayed wake up
yeah.
to get okay. around love.
Venting. Oh, wow! That was a very goofy block. Okay, FD's the missile.
JH is pretty much as good as Kai's, it feels like sometimes.
Yeah. Alright, gets hit there. Rumper takes game one.
Okay.
Alright. We're gonna charge a lot of meter here. Oh god, I couldn't tell what was going on between the items and the missiles. Like, just kind of overlapping with each other on the screen.
Just all the screen trash.
Alright. Trying to air, not getting anything off of it. Oh! Blocks the dust! Gets opened up anyway by the chop. Dumbbell. Delayed wake up. I keep forgetting that, I always forget that Robokai has that, and then I mistime my 5k.
Oh yeah.
And then on top of his really good EP too, so. Alright, another knockdown.
Fortunately, Gunflame is relatively doesn't care. Relatively.
More. Okay. Oh no! Oh, this is how it starts! Oh, this is how it starts! Oh no!
Now, health is even. Ish?
If this happens again, where Newt. Oh, okay, god.
Okay, gets the chop.
Newt, I was so scared for you there. Oh, man. I don't know if, like, he tried to maybe, like, time it so that he didn't explode on himself, but. Oh, that was very scary.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Okay, it was misinput door, yeah. Okay. Oh, that's so. The amount of mileage that Rumper got off of that was frightening. Heck you, I was rooting for you during the Elven set. Shut up. Leave me alone. Heaven or hell. Duel. One. Let's rock. All right.
Opens up missiles.
Why does Robokai have a horse?
It's Robokai.
We just want to walk everywhere.
Yeah. I wonder if that's a One Piece reference.
By the way, when Robokai uses horse and I use Grand Viper, we just
you
like,
go under it.
Pass.
Oh, is it like when is it like with Ryujin?
The night.
Is it like extra Ryujin and Grand Viper? Or you just, I guess, kind of sail over your head, but we stay?
No, I go through.
Oh, okay.
So, it's just like two ships passing in the night type of thing going on.
Alright, Newt's on set point. Oh, they got switched mid-set. That's goofy. Okay. Yeah, Newt's on set point.
The bust out. Used his own bus for not much. Did get the scalpel.
Alright, dumbbell coming through. Any Faust kind of cross up. Alright.
Oh, getting some nice stuff with the items here.
Yeah, items are finally helping him out. They interrupted the charge, they interrupted Rumper's combo, and then Newt took that advantage of that opening very well. So, Newt will take it 2-1, so he moves on to fight Omega Tom Hanks in Losers Quarterfinals. We'll swap over to the other side of Losers, so we'll get 8-man and Elven Shadow back on here. So, more Faust action. Different Fausts.
Infinite Faust.
Yeah. Literally! How many Fausts were there? Let's count them. Let me go through the bracket and count them. Okay, Siam, right? Formal Eli. Newt, Papple, Elvin, T-Spin. Six?
Yeah, six.
Jesus Christ. Why are you guys- what do you guys-
20% of the bracket was Faust.
Yeah. Jesus Christ. This, where do you guys come from? Where do they make you? Anyway.
About two other Fausts, too.
Wait, were there two other ones? Who were the ones I'm forgetting? Who are the ones that we don't remember? Eight? 8 out of 31 players were Faust. Yeah, that's enough to start a Wu-Tang Clan revival group.
And once again, we have the Faust.
Yeah, so the Faust against 8-Man. Alright, dive kick. I mean, 8-Man has done it before in this bracket against the Faust. Statistically speaking, he has to have, but like he also did fight with Newt and put Newt in misery, so.
I wonder what the longest anyone went in this bracket without fighting a Faust was.
That's a good question. Let's take a look at that. I'm sorry, Elvin, I'm not providing your match any good commentary. This is just more fun for me. I want to see... Okay, so obviously everyone in round one who had to fight a Faust failed, right?
Yeah.
So it looks like Naj failed at round two. Tom will fight a Faust next set. Jason Riot obviously hasn't. I don't think Jason Riot's fought a Faust yet. And this dog is a Faust. Elvin Shadow takes game one. Let's see. I was gonna say I did find a Faust as he bring out Elf and Cannon.
Shots fucking fired.
I fucking guess. Oh man. It looks like so in conclusion, it looks like everyone but Jason and Tom failed this failed the Don't Fight Faust challenge in round two. By round two. So those are the only two players who haven't fought a Faust yet, but they will. Like unless Tom or 8-Man somehow manage to win here, Jason will potentially fight a Faust, no matter what. Like, even if Jason wins against Skeletal, he will have to fight a Faust. Or even if he wins or loses against Skeletal, he'll have to fight a Faust. Goodness gracious. There's so many of you. Anyway, as we contemplate the enormity of the RNG in this bracket, Elvin stuns 8-Man and takes
one
it.
One could also say it's extremely consistent bracket.
Yeah. Oh man. I feel like that that Angry Video Game Nerd skit about football on the Atari 2600. Everywhere you go, Faust!
Faust 91, Faust 92, Faust 93.
Alright, so we'll have another Faust. We'll have Newt versus Omega Tom Hanks. Oh man. And out of all Guilty Gear characters, it's the one people come the most fucking hate ship over. Makes them play like fucking maniacs. Oh god. Alright, so Tom has to win this. Or else there will be a Faust mirror match in loser semis. So please stop this. As much as I hate to root for Potemkin, it's very difficult for me.
Potemkin is the hero.
Yeah, it's very difficult for me to pick sides because on one hand I don't want Newt to be cursed by WNF anymore. But on the other hand,
there's a pot buster and heat knuckle. Grab and,
Tom also has full meter here. He can do literally whatever he wants. Okay. He could just stay. You could just stay right there.
Pogo dodges Whitehead.
Yeah. Cuz he's not on the ground.
Yeah?
Yeah, so Tom can literally stay here for the next 55 seconds. You don't have to approach. I know you want... it would be more fun for me if you approached, but you don't have
to
approach.
The problem is that the not-approaching game plan for Potemkin is not great.
I guess that's true. He'll have to deal with items and stuff.
Yeah, items not fun.
Jason, don't leave! Jason, you're in winner's finals! Don't leave while I'm talking about a different set. I need offline to come back so that I can hold Jason by the collar.
Mm-hmm.
So that he doesn't go anywhere. So that you don't wander off. Like the children
he's also not in California. So.
Like the children that I have to take care of at my day job. Okay, so Newt is bringing it back, so now Newt is forcing Tom to play aggressively. Meanwhile, Newt can stay, Newt can stay away if he wants to. Oh, God. Okay, one.
Yeah.
Goodness gracious. All right, Tom. Thanks, Tom. Thanks, Tom. Heck you. You guys have to subscribe in order for me to make money from Casting Plus R. But I don't promote the subscription button. I promote the Matcherino instead. Heaven or hell. Duel. One. Let's rock.
Oh god, no, please.
No, Jen!
No.
Oh man. Alright, so we get the Karate Chop. Yeah, actually, get Pokimane to sponsor my stream. Pokimane will do it. I have like a semi-direct line to Pokimane. I wonder if I could take advantage of that.
Okay, Fulmida. That was a weird clash.
Yeah, Newt has nowhere to go. He has to spin burst if he needs to go anywhere. Oh, he actually managed to do it without
ahead. Burst. Potemkin not really blessed with the ability to fly.
Yeah.
Except doing heavenly, which is, you know, a thing.
All right, more pokes, butt stomp, knock. Okay, heat knuckle, knockdown. Oh, but that's invulnerable. What was that gold burst there? Was that a misinput? That had to be.
These hammerfalls doing good work.
Oh, okay. People just mash when they see that. They don't wait to think about what. They don't wait to think about where the angel is. I always wait.
No.
I know that if you wait too long, it goes without you doing anything. But I always think about it. All right. So Omega Tom Hanks preventing the Faust mirror in loser semi.
This is just this is the level 8 Nago. Now you need to fight the level 9 Nago.
Yeah, that's true. That's basically exactly what this is. This is the boss. This is the boss gauntlet. How many? Let's count before we move on to loser semis or winners finals. Let me just count how many. We were just saying that. So that was the first Faust that he had to fight. Right. Okay. Yeah. So that was the first Faust that he had to fight the whole time. So that was when he finally lost the Faust in a counter raid matchup. All right. So we'll hop over to winners finals in order to keep Jason Riot stimulated, prevent him from getting antsy.
Yeah, he needs to go to sleep and all that fun stuff, right?
Yeah. So we'll get Jason Riot Skeletal on here.
What if he had Matt Moon, right? But instead of Zubats, it was all Faust.
That would be terrifying. that's what this is. We should you should draw that for whoever ends up earning the next bounty. You should draw their character in like a cavern with like a bunch of bomb bag heads hanging from the ceiling.
Yeah. Okay. If the same thing happens next time. Or if the same thing happens whichever week there's a bounty and somebody claims it, I'll try to remember to do that.
Yeah. That'll be really good.
But I'm also going to forget to, like, write it down or anything, and it will just cease to be in my brain in about 5 minutes.
I'll remind you. Like, okay. I'll remind you daily.
Daily?
Yeah.
Daily.
Because, I mean, like, if it's habit forming, then you'll remember. Right? So then... So if I
that
so if I pav if I if I pav if I if I induce a Pavlovian response in you, then you'll remember, and then you'll be like, oh, I should do that for the next bounty winner.
She induce a Pavlovian response to these pets.
Anyway, god damn it. Anyways, we got Skeletal Jason.
Skeletal versus does knock down trivially Jason.
Yeah.
Via two buttons sweep.
Yeah. Usually, if anybody could, like, during the weeks where Jason was, like, very dominant, if anybody could do it, it was, like, one of three people. It was Elvin, Skeletor, or Joe. Elvin's still in bracket, and Joe slept through bracket, which means that Skeletor is our best shot at putting Jason in losers. And this is really fucked up. Jason has to burst if he wants to live.
It's time.
Yeah. Oh, so the air throw! Now Skeletor has to... Oh, the slashback!
Slashback!
Oh, but not good enough.
The slashback's real good. I'm just gonna run up and grab ya.
All right. Once again, we'll. Oh, reset. Slashback. Dead angle.
Busts Danzai, but Danzai is very good. So it ends up being a whiff bust.
All right. There we go.
And
yeah, that's the stagger loops that Skeletal wanted last time, but it didn't work. Probably.
Pulls out the command dash with nice fast buttons. Got back dash instead of what he wants to continue the sidewinder loop.
Okay. Force breaks out of there.
This time the 6P.
Oh, I think he wanted to run up wild throw.
Yeah.
I'm just calling that out right there. Okay, throw
that's
reset.
That's very ambitious when Abba is, I want to push buttons mode.
Yeah. I mean, I guess it beats Donzai armor, question marks? But oh! Volcanic, wait, did that Volcanic Viper go through Donzai?
That was DPs, okay. Was Volcanic Viper beating Donzai.
Yeah, okay, yeah. We'll go back, let's go back to the conversation we were having like an hour ago, and we'll just say Volcanic Viper is still the most privileged DP in all fighting games.
Skeletal did grab the Grand Viper, which is somewhat upsetting to me.
Alright, so Skeletal
takes it.
Yeah, so Skeletal
that
takes
it. That is the most ABBA thing I've ever seen.
Alright, Skeletal takes game one. Remember, this is best of five because this is winner's finals. Bloodbag to start things off. Okay. Yeah, short 5k 2D combos to run the timer down. Where's the block again, though? What's his frame data on that? He did like three in a row. And it...
But the Rekkas?
Yeah, on Rekka 1 or whatever.
Let's see.
He just did three of that in a row and like delayed and then did a third one like, and like Jason just had to block there.
Rekka 1 is minus 5.
Oh, okay, that's not too
bad.
That
makes sense.
It's probably the spacing or something that makes it hard to punish.
Yeah.
Okay, there we go. That's the run-up wild throw that Jason was looking for last game.
Sidewinders.
4. Okay. Probably should have just gone for revolver
there. Not being clean hit,
yeah.
So. Grand Viper. He RC's 2P.
Oh my god. I guess he wants to stay in. Okay. Risk edge slowly coming down. All right, building, racking it back up again. Okay, ID back to reset. Yeah. Recognizes that he was on low health, so he had to, like, fade away. Okay. Even round count. Okay, one knockdown. Two knockdown.
Two knockdowns. Three okay. Knockdowns!
We're gonna run our shit!
Clean hit! Look at that damage.
Oh no!
Blocks the key grab.
Yeah, this looks real bad for Skeletal. I mean, still has burst, still has two blood bags, but
yeah, but
okay,
not enough.
Yeah, we'll try again next game, I guess. Skeletal minion says in his head. I'm narrating his thought processes. Oh! That was very bold. Alright, another wall throw.
Wall throw into Sidewinder. Bust the second Sidewinder. Oh, now we're in this exit style combo. Ha!
Oh, really good banner revolver.
Really
good.
Yeah.
So we're gonna close that out. Dust loop. Oh! Okay.
One more hit!
Yeah.
Yeah.
It worked. I hope you're happy with that. By the
it wasn't
way.
Even. It was after the round ended.
Yeah.
The round ended because the Mafia chipped them out.
All right. Okay. Burst out of the dust loop, or Sidewinder. Okay. Oh, another one. Yeah. Getting a lot of mileage out of him. 2, 3.
Yeah, relatively short one. Probably wanted to end it on the right, on a good side. Working on this perfect.
Yeah, he got it.
Yep.
All right, so that's 3-1. Oh no, that was 2-1. Excuse me, I miscounted. I guess I put the score in too early. Don't worry, it's got blood. Heaven or hell. All right, here we go again.
Okay. It's a good cowhead trade there.
Not contesting Jason when he falls down. Not trying to continue the combo after the after it ends. Not trying to stop him from coming down. He was holding down back. Okay. Pass the pop. Yeah, there we go.
With the Grand Viper, though.
Alright, here
hey,
we go.
This is a big hit. Bust out of it.
Okay. Empties blood gauge to heal up and exit safely. Okay. Neat little poke.
Jage is so good.
Yeah, he gets a lot of. Yeah. He gets a lot of. Mileage out of those like error meaty JHs. Alright, here we go again. Working on another perfect. Let's knock down. Okay.
Again! Polishing the
small
activation.
Oh, okay.
Goku with a Grand Viper.
Yep. Alright, Jason Wright's on set point here. Okay, JP's.
Uses a buff. One knockdown.
Two
knockdowns.
Okay, getting a little bit greedy with the third one, but yeah, that works.
Got it.
Alright. That's a dead scalpel. It should
yeah.
be, unless. Oh, wow!
Dropped!
Okay.
But Gunflame
yeah.
gets it.
Yeah, there we go.
I would have loved to see Napalm Death there.
Yeah, I guess he just doesn't want to do it, but...
It's really hard to pull off there. Like, yeah, I'm not sure even if it even works.
Yeah. Alright, so Skeletal gets sent to Losers, where he will now await the winner of Omega Tom Hanks vs. Elven Shadow. So this will be really, so this little small Faust gauntlet that will make that Omega Tom has to navigate.
It's straight up Nago Stage 8 into Nago Stage 9.
Yeah. And Elven Shadow.
Elven does not cheat like Nago Stage 9 does, or Stage 8.
Yeah.
DJ doesn't cheat that badly.
I worked really hard to get those achievements.
I still haven't gone stage 9, actually.
The trick is... I mean, the trick is, for both of them, is that the Nago AI doesn't know what to do if you pause buffer tick throw.
Yeah.
So I just abused that.
I don't even know how to tick throw, okay?
Alright, so now, yeah, so now this is an even more dangerous Faust, so...
Yeah.
Tom may have made, like, the Newt matchup look, like, in his favor, but this is Frosty Fausting's own...
The Newt matchup was also still pretty close.
Yeah, that's also true. It was like a...
Backdash
yeah.
Pop Buster, the classics.
Yeah. I'm glad I can't do that anymore as Strife. I'm glad they doesn't have a 22 frame backdash anymore. Sorry,
yeah.
Not sorry.
You have to actually like do committal-ish things now.
Although he does get Garuda, so whatever.
Does get Garuda. Garuda is mean.
Alright, what could all these be? Oh, he got hit by
everything.
All that.
Everything. Yeah.
So he's trying to navigate Toho with the fucking tennis ball.
Yeah. Oh, okay. There we go. Potbuster 1.
Into the heat knuckle.
That was like a clean 50% off of one throw. Oh, tries to go for it again. Okay, we will get another
heat knuckle, yeah. So one more good hit.
Yeah. Very good use of the Hammerfall break armor to get something started there. Jumps over Gigantrakai. Get all that candy! Oh. I wanted to get the candy. Elvin got the candy. Alright, block string. Elvin has a lot of meter to play with here, too, so.
Yeah.
Oh! Okay. What a combo! I can't believe that didn't kill, actually. Oh! Fight yourself! Fight yourself! Oh, that's so funny! He probably knew, like, as he pressed, like, JD going down, he's like, oh no. He was like, oh no. Alright.
Blown up by his own love. Medias! Oh, just goes through all the medias with an air throw. Another set of medias.
Oh, okay.
And gets through all the medias with a blockbuster!
That's a very smart way to avoid them. If you're going to avoid them, I guess that'll be how you do it. Okay. I didn't see what item went off screen there. I'm assuming it doesn't matter. Okay, still even after getting hit by Mini Faust. Will he knuckle kill? No. Oh!
Yes.
Okay. Oh. Okay, there we go. Meteors almost broke the lobby.
Second grab, one more grab.
All oh
stuff,
god.
Couple of bombs.
Okay. Yeah, we're healthy enough to be like kind of okay here. And he's also gonna get burst back soon. Oh, but is he gonna get stunned? Oh, the what? Okay. Washpan would have stunned him. But, yeah. But it just killed him.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That was burst safe. Okay, good flick on the item.
The bomb.
Yeah. All right, this is where we get to. This is where Tom gets to play now. Gigantrakai. Oh, drops the combo. Good back dash. Okay. What could all these be? Oh man. Oh man. Yeah, this is uphill.
Oh yeah.
Tom, I believe in you. Oh, that's fine.
Okay.
Yeah, that was there was not much to be done there. Alright, so Elvin takes it. That was loser semi, so that's just the best of three. So Elvin takes it to fight Skeletal. This is the WNF Classic, although before Jason Ride used to pull through, this was actually Grand Finals.
Let's see if Jason has to fight a Faust and actually escape the night.
Yeah, so there is a possibility, there is a 50% possibility that Jason Riot
it's
will be.
Jackbox
yeah.
was a mystery thing.
Yeah.
Escaping the fouls.
This there is a possibility that this is that Jason ends up being the only person to not fight a foul tonight. 50-50 chance. All right, so this is also best of five, since this is just finals. Are we having the lobby bug again? I have a feeling we have the lobby bug again.
Pings for everybody.
Oh, okay, no, they're mashing. Good.
Yeah.
Tom, it is 3 frames. It's 3 frames for every reversal input. Scalda doing what he does best.
Elvin also does what Elvin does best.
One.
Galpel punishing the blood pack activation.
Oh, get the can. Ah.
That's two.
Okay. We're out to prevent
that. Reset.
Yeah. Oh god. Okay, Elvin takes game one. Oh, what the? What the? Thank you. Looked like I was turning Elvin into an Ava unit in the scoreboard. Okay, pokes. Oh, slashback! We're working our way in. I think Celta wants to pop blood with T-Grab in order to get more damage. But he'll probably just have to do it from the full screen. Because he's
like,
not getting any...
such
yeah.
a good answer to that.
Yeah, he's not getting opportunities to do anything that Abba likes to do. Okay, there we go. Oh, but
Bomb
then...
actually interrupted the key grab attempt. Goku!
Oh, good cross-up. That's the melty cross-up.
Big damage! Busts out!
Oh, goodness! Okay, FRC's the blood drink.
Resources, though.
Oh, but the...
really low health!
Oh god, okay. Well that, yes.
Wow.
What a clutch air confirm.
Yeah.
I'm like babbling, because like I'm so scared of what their interaction. Alright, yeah, this is what Skeletal wants. Oh no! this time first. Okay, good Danzai.
Danzai answers the J2K.
Corner to corner, Oki on the fireball. Happy little reset. Oh, that was a really good dead angle punish.
Yeah.
Okay, he has to get something that'll let him cash
like
out.
Grab.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, thus.
There you go. Okay, yeah, he drank his blood
pack. Gets out safe.
Because he was like one touch there.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Okay. Oh, he's looking for it again!
Yeah!
Okay. Alright, normal ABBA. Okay, yeah,
Scalpel extended the hotbox so the projectile hit.
That game just then reminded me of a set that I played against Hekyu on stream when Ruben was still doing this, where Hekyu beat me without once going into Maruha. And that was the most embarrassing
thing. I remember you
thing.
Complaining about that.
That was the most embarrassed and upset I have been.
See, you're well known for your IK ways, and if he never goes into Moroha,
then he can't do it. Yeah, I can't do it. Yeah. he won't let me do it. Okay. Alright, here. Oh, happy little reset. We intended to drop it to go to Goku.
Gets the hit. Drops it, though.
Oh, eat the donut! Ah!
Oh, I almost got the donut. Bust!
Eat the candy bar! Okay, he didn't need it.
Didn't need it. The only point of life that matters is the last one.
I'm gonna get a clip of you saying eat the candy bar and put that on the soundboard.
Alright, here we go again. Alright. We're spending. Oh, gets poked out. Okay, burst to stay in. The bajillions of overheads. Okay,
yeah.
It takes that before Elvin can get burst back. Alright, Skeleton up on the set. Oh boy. You know, historically this goes back and forth, so Elvin's still not, like, Skeleton's not out of the woods yet. Elvin can absolutely do this.
Sweep into key grab.
Okay. Overheads. Alright, good throw.
Okay, takes throw into nice big combo. Now has the meter for Goku, does the activation. Lots of risk. Oh, gets a hit, busts it though. And then Danzai gets
another good
Danzai.
Hit. Elvin can't escape
damage.
This. Yeah.
Big
yeah.
damage.
That was gross.
Yep.
Alright, Skeletal's on set point. If Skeletal wins this, again, just as a reminder, if Skeletal wins this, Jason Ryan will be the only person in bracket to have never fought a Faust tonight. Which is actually kind of why I want to see Elvin win this.
Jason was sharing the cost.
Yeah, Jason has to suffer like everyone else suffered.
Light is raising the Bayonet above his head and sacrificing
Skeletal
minions so that
so that I get the
Jason can't escape his fate.
Okay, Goku activation.
Alright, this is the last, this could potentially be the last burst of the set. Oh! Okay, guess is wrong on the treasure chests. Okay, Elvin Shadow staying alive.
Bizarre interaction there.
Yeah.
Okay. weird clashes this round.
Okay, Goku. Okay, it doesn't get counter hit.
Gets the hit in though, and big damage.
Yeah, that was only 7 gets hits. The risk was so built up. All right. Okay. All right.
My way, Chip does it though.
Yeah, Elvin's staying alive. So even set count. We're in game 5 now. All right, let's have at it. Okay, popping at the max distance to not get punished by Scalpel.
Yeah.
This is another knockdown, though.
Gets the hit. Into the bust.
Has enough meter to pop Maroha. I imagine we'll see it. Yes.
Right there, but it's not a continuation of the combo. This does get Danzai anyway. Now, lots of damage.
We're at...
Gets out of the mode safely.
I think he wanted an air throw there, but it worked out in his favor anyway. Scalpel on set point. Okay, OTG. The little OTG.
OTG.
Okay,
gold buff.
Yeah. What could all of these be? Not going for the 100 meter version. Or no, was that the 100 meter version? No, it wasn't. It was good.
No.
Looking at the wrong bars. Alright, yeah. Skeletal in a very favorable position here. Elvin has all the meter, but I mean, one touch is all he needs to confirm something. And Elvin doesn't have burst. This could be it. Okay, no, we're gonna get our health back first. We're too far away from the corner for that to be a thing. Oh, that's it!
The pogo! That's it!
Jason, oh, man.
Escapes the Faust!
Yeah, Jason escapes needing to play against the Faust.
That is called dodging a matchup right there.
Oh, man. Yeah, Jason. Yeah,
Jason
that
is breathing the world's biggest sigh of relief right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, especially since like most of Soul specials don't even function properly on a crouching Faust.
Yeah.
I was like, I'm gonna Bandit bring a nude once, and then just like completely whiffed. I'm like, really?
Yeah, a lot of like,
really?
a lot of jam BNB on the wall, like the wall loops with 5K, 6H, those all drop on Faust. That's so. I don't know why this character gets to do that. Alright.
I mean, once I get a hit in, then it's like not the worst, but like getting that first hit in is suffering. Yeah.
Alright, so Jason has to get back in here. I will at you on the Discord. I know you know what you have to do. Alright. That's a good question. Jason, are you going to Frosty? You better be. I'm not going to Frosty, but you better be going to Frosty. Just rig the seating, Smile. I did that tonight. You can do that. Alright, so here, let me put the L in Skeletal Minion so that we know. So remember, Skeletal's coming in from loser's side, which means he has to win 6 games. On the other hand, Jason only needs to win 3. Okay, good burst.
The Grand Viper. Yeah.
Oh, whiffing like a bajillion Danzais there. But it's fine. Okay.
Oh, Stomp. That's a move I don't see Jason use that often.
Yeah.
Okay, almost out.
Okay.
Use blood packs to get out safely.
Yeah, drinks the heal. The HP deficit is really high right now. Obviously,
and
Jason.
A lot higher when.
Oh, okay. Stuffs the dash. Okay. Yeah.
I didn't see the time wave though. Why did you time wave?
I like. Oh, there we go.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. We're gonna save our burst for next round. All right, here we go. Okay, I like these FD breaks. These uncharacteristic FD breaks from Jason run up while throws soul.
Yeah.
Like he knows that he
not getting a chance to use the blood pack. There he goes.
Yeah. All right, Danzai. We'll see. Okay, Skeletal going for, he's going for these. I think these are recessed to bait burst.
Probably.
Yeah. Okay. Risk it.
Goku! Again punished with Grand Viper, but that time did not get the clean hit, so couldn't follow up on it.
Jason has been incredibly ready for these Goku pops all night.
Yeah.
Oh, bait burst.
Yep. Knew you had to burst right then on that hit.
All right, here we go again.
K is a privileged move. Flashback. Gets the Sidewinder to... Misses the Banner Revolver second half. Grand Viper gets punished real hard for it.
Okay, we have... Okay, there we go. That should do it.
Yeah.
That was very scary because of the health drain. Oh, Slashback!
JP, however, greater than Slashback.
Oh, what? That was a odd
whiff. So easy to just mash.
I wonder why that didn't he grab OTG.
Who knows? Okay. Counter hit Riot Stomp into the Sidewinders. Just raw key grabs on wake up. Goku?
Okay.
Gets the air grab for the last hit and.
Yeah, gets a game.
Skeletal gets a game.
Okay, Rekka 1 still being, I mean, I guess not minus enough.
Minus 5 is not minus enough.
Yeah.
Like, Tower Wave is minus 6. Yeah.
Fuck off. Alright, FRC Gunflame to stay in. Okay, good stuff. Wall throw.
For the knockdown there.
Yeah, doesn't want to risk anything
just
that
to prevent the knockdown.
Yeah. That was very interesting. He spent Blood Pack to escape because he didn't have enough meter from Roha, but then he goes right back in with Blood Pack. Okay. Oh, wow. That's very interesting. I wonder what Skelpel is thinking here with like the use of his resources. Maybe he's thinking he'll get it back next round?
Surprising drops on Jason's part.
Yeah.
Jason eventually getting it, but yeah.
Okay. Ooh, okay. Good air throw. Directly into those who you can make grab.
Wake up, Vivi. Danzai. So much risk now. Had to block the Goku, so couldn't do the Grand Viper punish that they've been doing before. Whiffs the JD. Now it's Skeletal's turn to do big damage.
Okay. Oh no!
Oh.
Yeah, he wanted something. He just wanted desperately to get Jason away. But
yeah.
Alright, so Jason's on tournament point here. One game away from winning WNF, like, for the 10th fucking time.
Something like that. Catches the backdash with the key grab.
Alright, just straight up going for this.
Oh, didn't get the sweep that time, so needs a little bit more.
Okay, Muroha. Alright, we're tracking Jason down. We're not gonna let him run away. Yeah, that'll do.
I'll do it. It's one hit. This time catches the command dash. But now combo gets the command throw anyway.
Oh goodness.
And that's it for that game. Reset point.
Yeah, so if Skeletal wins this, then Jason Ryan has to do it 3 more times. But if Jason wins this, he gets to go to bed early. Okay, slashback attempt. First makes key grab whiff. Very goofy interactions here at round start. Oh, baits the gold burst, but still gets hit on landing. Alright. Abba things,
including Danzai!
Okay, DP but knockdown.
Also, soul things.
Another DP knockdown.
Yeah. Not very much left.
Okay, just exit safely.
And then immediately goes back in with a key grab. Volcanic Viper! Yeah.
That should do it. Yeah.
And now for the
he doesn't even have to get fancy.
Combos.
Yeah. Alright, Jason's on tournament point, so we'll see this.
Basic stuff.
Abba's not Muroha right now. You can do real combos this time.
Yeah.
Alright, looking really bad for Skeletal here. I think that should do it, actually.
That should.
Oh,
but
the
Jason
yeah.
dropped it.
Yeah. Okay. Well, he's very close to getting this. Skeletal has to work really hard here. Burst is gonna be back on deck soon.
Hey, if Jason isn't allowed to play the game again, which is very possible here.
Yeah. All right. Another. Okay. Okay. Yeah.
The Fafnir chip damage does it.
Yeah. Wasn't FDing there, and Jason Riot is your fleece for the first bracket of 2022. Jason Riot is once again your winner, edging it out over Skeletal Minion again, avoiding a Faust through the entire bracket, which is insane when you think about how there's eight Fausts, which means roughly you had a 25% chance.
One full chance just to play a Faust round one.
Yeah, so that was really fucked up. So, but yeah, so, good stuff to everybody tuned in and who played. Yeah, so we had 31 entrants tonight. So largest plus R bracket that we've had in the past couple of months, especially since Strive came out. So, thanks again to all of you guys for tuning in and supporting. Remember to check out the Match Reno. There's still a bunch of codes left on the table, and there's still a bunch of you in chat, so make sure to use those codes. Don't let them go to waste. We will be back at this next week with more of this. If Jason Riot wins again next week, he will reinitiate the bracket and the bounty, at which point the opportunity to earn one of Kim's pieces of art will be on the table again. In the meantime, I think that basically does it. So we'll go raid Pat, who seems to be playing Melty Blood tonight. Thanks again so much to you guys, everybody, for watching. I've been Light the Iron Man. I was once again joined by my co-TO Kimberly.
That's me.
And my co-commentator Tux Dev.
Yeah.
So, that does it for us tonight. Have a good rest of your Feliz Jueves. Make sure to stay safe, stay healthy, play Guilty Gear, and when you get to Pat's stream, be sure to tell him the cow sent you. So, we will see you guys. Hang on, raid. Excuse me, raid. Okay, I spelled it wrong. Okay. So I'll see you guys next week for more Plus R action, and have a good rest of your night.